students of class 3, I hope that you all are fine and doing great at home. Welcome to another class. Today we are going to start a new chapter that I hope that you all are going to enjoy. So what is the date today? Yes, Iman? Yes, today is 2nd December 2020. And what is the day today? Yes, it's Wednesday. Which unit number we are going to start today? Yes. The story of silk. आज हम सिल्क की कहानी पढ़ेंगे. Before starting our unit, we should all know the meanings of the difficult words so that it will be easy for us to understand the sentences and it will be easy for us to translate them in Urdu. Do you like this house? Who will tell me that from where the silk comes? Silk कहाँ से आती है? Who will tell me? From where it comes? Do you have any idea? चलो. If you don't have any idea, you will have all the idea and you will know about it after reading this chapter. So let's start it. First of all, we write the difficult words so that we know what are the meanings of these words. The first word that we have over here is artifacts. What is artifacts? Artifacts kya hote hain? Who will tell me? Artifacts. Just interesting objects hote hain, they are known as artifacts. What is bearing? Bearing is some kind of the things that we wear, how we stand, how we move on anything, if we are suffering from anything, if we are finding anything difficult, how we are standing on it, how we are moving on it. We can say that this is the person's way of standing or moving. The next word that we have over here is cocoon. What is cocoon? Cocoon. What is cocoon? This is kind of an insect. Just like we have grasshoppers in our fields, this is just like that, a silky case formed by insects such as caterpillars. Okay, who will tell me the meaning of confined? Confined. the things that we keep in a specific place or a specific area that is known as confined. Okay? Custom. Custom is like a habit or traditional way of behaving, like we all have our own customs, how we behave, what traditions do we have in our culture. Just like the Pakistanis, we are different from Indians. Indians are different from Australians. Australians are different from British or American people. So we all have our different customs. Customs are the way of living, the behavior, the traditions that we have in our region. That is known as custom. Okay, the next one that we have over here is elaborate. Fatima, tell me, what is elaborate? Elaborate karna kya hota hai? Yes, किसी चीज को whenever we define anything in detail, carefully made or with law, so define detail, that is known as elaborate. It can be taken in two senses, like whenever you carefully make anything, or whenever anything is defined with a lot of detail, or anything is defined detailly, so that is known as elaborate. This is the word that we use in our sentences mostly, that please elaborate it. हम कहते हैं ना प्लीज इसको मज़ीद डिटेल में बताएं, टेल अस इन डिटेल, एलैबोरेट इट, दैट दिस इज नोन एज एलैबोरेट. एम्परर, एम्परर इज द रूलर ऑफ एन एम्पायर. किसी भी जगह का, किसी भी प्लेस का जो लीडर होता है, जो उस जगह को चलाता है, द रूलर इज, द रूलर ऑफ एम्पायर इज नोन एज द एम्परर. एम्परर, whenever we eat anything, any snacks or biscuits or any other thing, you can read on it. It is manufactured in Pakistan, manufactured in America, or the clothes that we buy. So it shows us that where something is made. Koi bhi cheez kahan banayi gayi hai, that is known as made. The last word that we have over here is wearer. A person who makes clothes by crossing threads over in each under each other. Weaver is a word that we use whenever you are making any clothes. So whatever, what you do, you put the threads on one and other, and that is how a cloth is made. कोई भी कपड़ा किस तरह से बनता है, जब आप उसको उनके जो धागे हैं वो एक दूसरे के ऊपर नीचे आते हैं, तो किसी फैक्ट्री में whenever, if you ever went to any factory, or if you have any chance of seeing how the clothes are made, so you might have observed ke kis tarah se dhage ek dusre ke upar aate hain, kis tarah se unki printing hoti hai, aur kis tarah se kapda aapke paas bankar aata hai. So this is weaver. Start reading. I hope that you all are having lead pencils in your hand, and you can underline that any other difficult word that you find, and then you can ask me the meaning of those words in the WhatsApp group or on Google Classroom, and you can also use dictionaries to find the meanings of those words. It will be better if you find the meanings of the dictionary from by yourself. It will remain in your comprehension for as long. Let's start it. Did you know that silk was discovered in China? Did you know that? That it was first discovered in China? What do you know about China? Yes, China is our neighborhood country, and it is a friend of Pakistan. Great. A long time ago, in a tiny village in China, there lived a poor girl belonging to a weaver's family. अब हम लोगों ने वेवर्स के बारे में पढ़ा है, वो क्या होते हैं? जो कपड़ा बनाते हैं बाय पुटिंग द थ्रेड्स ओवर वन अनदर, एक दूसरे के ऊपर धागा चढ़ा चढ़ा के जो लोग कपड़ा बनाते हैं, जो क्लोथ्स बनाते हैं, उनको वेवर कहते हैं. ठीक है. कीप वन थिंग इन योर माइंड व्हेन एवर यू आर रीडिंग, यू शुड टेक केयर ऑफ द कॉमास एंड द फुल स्टॉप्स दैट आर कमिंग इन द पैराग्राफ. हाफ जो फुल स्टॉप्स हैं वहाँ पे आपने कंप्लीट पॉज लेना है, जो कॉमास जहाँ पे आएंगे वहाँ पे आपने हाफ पॉज लेना है. सो वन डे द एम्परर वॉज पासिंग थ्रू द विलेज एंड सॉ हर वर्किंग इन द फील्ड्स. ही नोटिस हर प्रिटी फेस, हर प्राउड बियरिंग एंड हर रफ वर्क वॉर्न हैंड्स, विच मीन्स शी वर्क्ड वेरी हार्ड थ्रू द ईयर. He immediately fell in love with her and thought he was so much older, decided to marry her. Whenever you are reading, whenever you are trying to improve your accent, you should take care of the phonics of the words. If you find any word difficult, you can just do its phonics. जिस तरह उर्दू में हम लोग किसी भी लफ्ज़ के तोड़ जोड़ करके उस लफ्ज़ को, उस जुमले को पढ़ने की कोशिश करते हैं, similarly you can do this with English. You just have to do the phonics of that difficult word. And if you want to improve your accent, what you have to do, you have to do the maximum reading as much as you can using the 3 or 4 important letters. And what are those letters? You have to call T as H, P as H, C and K as K. So if you will use these three letters as these sounds, T, P and K, your accent will automatically improve. And if you really want to improve your accent, you must practice reading on a daily basis. Let's continue. The girl married the ruler of the land and went to live in his palace as his beloved queen. But she was unhappy. She had grown up in the wide open spaces of the countryside. And now she was confined to a palace, magnificent though it was. She was used to working from dawn to night without a moment's rest, but now she had many servants to take care for her needs and did not know how to fill her time. In the village, she had been surrounded by family and friends who exchanged news and gossip as they walked, but in the palace, it was quiet, no one spoke of turn. The emperor noticed his new wife was sad and tried his best to make her happy. He bought her grand clothes, jewels and artifacts, threw elaborate parties, hired the best musicians of the land to amuse her, yet she was sad. Who understood what we have learned, what we have read till now? Who is going to translate it? Let's translate. बहुत टाइम पहले चाइना के छोटे से गांव में एक लड़की रहती थी, एक गरीब लड़की जो कि एक विवर के ख़ानदान से ताल्लुक़ रखती थी, वो ख़ानदान जो कपड़े बनाता था. उसी वक़्त उसी दिन एक दिन जौन सा है वहाँ से उस गांव का जौन सा है वो बादशाह गुजरा, उसका रूलर गुजरा, और उसने उस लड़की को खेतों में काम करते हुए देखा. वो इतनी खूबसूरत थी और इस कदर अच्छे और मेहनत से काम करती हुई नज़र आ रही थी कि बादशाह को उसे देखते ही प्यार हो गया, उस रूलर को. ठीक है. और उसने उसी से शादी करने का फैसला किया. अब उस रूलर की उससे शादी हो गई और उसके बाद वो लड़की जौन सी है उसकी मलका बनकर उसके महल में आकर रहने लगी. लेकिन वो वहाँ आकर बहुत ही नाखुश थी. Who will tell me why was she sad? इसलिए क्योंकि उसे गांव में रहने की आदत थी, ऐसी जगहों पर जो बहुत खुली जगह होती थी, और अब उसे सिर्फ एक महल में महदूद कर दिया गया था. उसे सुबह से लेकर रात तक बिना किसी आराम के काम करते रहने की आदत थी और अब उसके पास कई ज़्यादा मुलाजिम थे जो उसकी ज़रूरतों का ख्याल रखते थे और उन्हें समझ नहीं आता था कि उसका वक्त किस तरह से गुजरवाएं। गांव में वो अपने फैमिली और अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ सराउंडेड रहती थी, उनके इर्द गिर्द रहती थी, वो बातें करते थे, एक दूसरे को नई नई खबरें सुनाते थे। लेकिन महल में हर तरफ बहुत ज़्यादा खामोशी थी। एम्परर जो वहाँ का था, उसने नोटिस किया कि उसकी बीवी जौन सी है वो अफसरदा है। उसने बहुत कोशिश की कि अपनी बीवी को खुश करे। उसने उसे नए कपड़े लेके दिए, ज्वेलरी लेके दी, उसने बहुत ही ढेर सारे इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट्स लेके आया उसके सामने, इंटरेस्टिंग ऑब्जेक्ट्स लेके आया, उसने कई कई बड़ी पार्टीज दी, उसने सबसे अच्छे मौसीकी का जो गुलकार होते हैं, म्यूजिशन होते हैं, उनको बुलाया ताकि वो उसे खुश कर सके। लेकिन फिर भी शी वॉज सैड। वन आफ्टरनून द एम्परर सैट अंडर अ मलबेरी बुश इन हर गार्डन, lost in her thoughts about her village. She slowly sipped hot water from a cup. Staring up at the blue sky, the girl remembered the birds that flew over her village. Then, sighing softly to herself, she picked up her cup to take another sip. But what was this? A cocoon from the mulberry bush had dropped into the hot water. Her first thought was to throw away the water in the cocoon. But then she took a closer look and she saw some threads peeping out from the cocoon. Where had they come from? She pulled the threads. They were thin, strong, and shiny. She kept pulling and a long line of thread came out. Now, the Empress had a great idea. She would take the thread from many cocoons and weave soft, strong cloth from it. She called her servant and everyone got to work. They took cocoons out of the mulberry tree, dropped them in hot water, and removed the thread. They gathered a fair amount of yarn. Then the queen ordered a special weaving machine and wove the first piece of cloth using this new thread. This was how silk, the best and brightest form of cloth, was weaved. The manufacture of silk spread throughout China. It was a cloth that only royalty could wear and was much in demand in lands as far as Rome. The route along with silk was traded between China and Europe through Asia and called the Silk Route. Now that the Chinese had learned how to make silk cloth, they did not want to share this knowledge with anyone in the world. For many years, all members of the Chinese royal family were sworn never to reveal the secret to anyone. When princesses got married and went away to far-off lands, they were not allowed to tell anyone in their new home how silk was made. Many, many years later, when a clever princess was leaving her house and getting married, as was the custom, her bags were searched carefully to check that she did not carry anything that would help her make silk. This princess had been weaving silk from a young age and wanted to continue to do so wherever she went. She had hidden the cocoons in her long, elaborate hairdo. No one thought of looking there. When she went to her husband's house, she took out these cocoons from her hair and started gathering silk thread. In this way, the legend goes, knowledge of how to make silk left China. वो आई थिंक दैट यू ऑल गेट टू नो दैट हाउ द सिल्क वॉज फॉर्म्ड। लेट्स कंटिन्यू द ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। एक सपहर जब वो एम्प्रेस एक मलबरी बुश के नीचे, एक मलबरी दरख्त के नीचे बैठी हुई थी, तो वो इतना अपने ख्यालों के बारे में खोई हुई थी, अपने गांव के बारे में सोच रही थी। उसने अपने कप में से हॉट वाटर पिया, एक सिप लिया, फिर परिंदों को देखने लग गई। फिर उसने दूसरा सिप लेने के जब अपना कप उठाया तो उसे देखा कि उसके अंदर क्या था। देयर वाज अ कोकून फ्रॉम द मलबेरी बुश जो उसके गर्म पानी में गिर गया था। पहले तो उसने सोचा कि वो पानी और कोकून दोनों को गिरा दे, लेकिन जब उसने क्लोजर लुक ली तो फिर उसने देखा कि उसके अंदर से थ्रेड्स निकल रहे हैं। और फिर उसके दिमाग में आइडिया आया कि क्यों ना वो इन तमाम कोकून्स को इकट्ठा करके इनके थ्रेड्स को कोकून्स को गर्म पानी में डाले और फिर उन थ्रेड्स को इकट्ठा करके सिल्क बनाए, कि एक जौन सा है वो कपड़ा बनाए, सॉफ्ट और स्ट्रॉन्ग क्लोथ बनाए। उसने यही किया, उसने अपने तमाम सर्वेंट्स को इन कामों पे लगा दिया। एंड देन फाइनली शी मेड क्लोथ, द मोस्ट फाइनेस्ट क्लोथ, सिल्क। ठीक है, अब सिल्क बनना शुरू हो गई। फॉर मैनी ईयर्स इट वॉज डिसाइडेड कि सिल्क का जो सीक्रेट है वो चाइना से बाहर नहीं निकलेगा। इवन जो प्रिंसेसेस थीं जिनके बाहर के और कंट्रीज़ में शादी होती थी, उनको भी ये स्वॉर्न किया जाता था कि वो किसी के साथ ये सीक्रेट शेयर नहीं करेंगी। एंटी नलेस एक लास्ट प्रिंसेस जो बहुत ही क्लेवर थी, शी हैड ऑलवेज मेड सिल्क, उसने हमेशा से जौन सा है वो सिल्क बनाई थी, इसने यही काम किया था। तो फिर अपने उसने बड़े से बालों में, इफ़ यू हैव ऑब्जर्व, तो जो चाइना के और जापान के लोग होते हैं उनके बड़े बड़े बंस बने हुए होते हैं उनके हेयर डूज में, तो उसने उन्हीं के अंदर कोकून्स जौन से हैं वो छुपा लिए थे। और फिर जब वो वहाँ गई, उसकी शादी होकर गई, तो फिर उसने वहाँ पर सिल्क बनाना शुरू कर दिया। एंड दैट वॉज द डे जब सिल्क का एक्चुअली चाइना से बाहर इस्तेमाल शुरू हुआ था, बनना शुरू हुई थी। एंड द सीक्रेट लेफ्ट चाइना, तो जो चाइना के अंदर जो सीक्रेट था सिल्क बनने का, वो वाकई उस दिन रिवील हो गया था। सो दिस इज़ द स्टोरी ऑफ सिल्क। आई होप दैट यू ऑल एन्जॉयड इट, इट वॉज pretty good story, it has something new for all of us. Yes, I didn't know the story of silk, that where it started, so we must acknowledge what we have learned today. Still, if you have any confusion, you can ask me in the WhatsApp group or on the Google Classroom. Take good care of yourselves. Allah Hafiz.